We're talking to Barry Nussbaum. How you doing, Barry?
Wonderful. Glad to be with you, of course.
Barry Nussbaum, got a question for you. We've been talking about Donald Trump's wall. Some people get mad when I call it Trump's wall. They say it's not Trump's wall, it's America's wall. But what does Donald Trump have to do to sell this project? Just take it away.
I think this is my Barry to President Trump plan. If the president is listening to your show today, which he should be, of course, he's got a plan to take to the State of the Union tomorrow. And this is what I think President Trump ought to do. I think you ought to start out with a little bit of historical perspective on national sovereignty and security. Going all the way back to the founders in the 18th century, the purpose, the prime directive of the federal government, the national government, is the protection of the homeland. And part of that is the defense of identifiable borders, which in the last, say, decade or so, the United States has abrogated. In many, many, many places along the border is nothing more than a line in the sand. And every country that abandons its borders gives up its sovereignty and its national identity. All the other stuff is a horrible byproduct, like crime and drugs and murder and rape and mayhem. Those are the byproducts of abandonment of those strong federal responsibilities. I think if he gives a historical perspective and then a tour around the world, and somehow if he could do an AV, you know, audio visual presentation, and show the wall in Hungary and the wall in Poland and the wall in Cyprus and Turkey and Jordan and Syria and Saudi Arabia and Qatar and Israel, all of which are 100% successful, and Morocco has a monster one, we're going to look like the odd child out. And I wish, Ken, somehow he could give a tour of the hypocrisy of the very wealthy, especially in the political party that says walls are racist and walls are amoral and walls should be torn down, except at Nancy's estate and Nancy's other estate and Joe Biden's estate and Al Gore's estate, not to mention the Hollywood celebrities that think Trump is a crazy man or a Nazi for wanting walls, and their walls are 25 feet high and in some cases topped with barbed wire. And then finally, I think if he talks about what's happening with crime, like the fentanyl bust last week that could have killed 150 million people, people are going to wake up to it. And the bottom line is, Ken, $5 billion is a rounding error on a weekend in the federal budget. And what I think you ought to do is list the programs that people don't know anything about, you've never heard of, and none of your panel has, like whale migration and bumblebee reproduction and North Pole seal populations, and list maybe 200 or 300 of these programs that cost a tremendous amount of money, and ask, which would you rather have, border security or know how bumblebees reproduce in the Southern Hemisphere?
Well, let me ask you this. Who is he trying to sell? Because he's not trying to sell the hardcore Democrats, because they don't care about security. What they want is to get as many Democrat voters to cross the border as they possibly can. So he could say, hey, these guys are bringing drugs in, they're bringing crime in. They don't care. As long as they're voting for Democrats, come on in. So who is he trying to sell?
I think he's talking over the heads of the people in the audience, the 535 members of the House and the Senate, and he's talking to the American people. Ken, that's why Nancy Pelosi blocked the State of the Union several weeks ago. She doesn't want him to talk to the American people about this. He's going to talk right over their heads. He's going to bypass the media. It's going to be on in most houses in America. And he's going to tell people, look, I can give you security and it's not going to cost you anything because I'm going to take it away from the bumblebee study. And if everything breaks down, the last resort, and I think you ought to say this in public, I'm going to declare a national emergency. There have been dozens and dozens and dozens declared in the last 30 years. And you don't know about it, and I don't know about it because they never publicize them. There's 28 national emergencies still on the books on stuff you wouldn't believe, from Obama and Bush going all the way back to President Clinton, and nobody cares. He has the power, he can do it, and then he can get his wall built.
Amen.
Hey guys, what do you think, Anthony?
Hey, you know, I think that Barry just laid it out there very, very eloquently. And this is a chance for our president, President Trump, to really, you know, talk with their heads and talk directly to the American people about this wall. And just like you were saying, Barry, the only thing that I would add is this. After he gets finished giving this historical perspective of the wall and the criminality that's, you know, ensuing because of it's not being built, he should turn around and point the finger right at Nancy Pelosi. He should talk about the blood that is on Nancy Pelosi's hands for not having that wall. He should turn around and face her directly, let all Americans see. He should talk about how she had her fingers crossed during the negotiation for this wall. She had no intent of ever negotiating in good faith about this wall. I want him to do everything exactly like you said, and then turn around and face her and point his finger at her.